Yeah, good morning students. I am Pavan, your science master. This video is for 7th standard students. Students, what we have been talking, did you remember? Yeah, we have been talking about electricity, current and its effects. Different sub-concepts related to this chapter we have been talking. Yes? Yes, students. Did you remember what specifically we have talked in the previous class? Yes, construction of dry cell and symbols of different electrical components. Students, I have shown you an image related to the electrical components and their symbols. Okay, students, I have drawn the symbols on the board. You can observe these symbols. Students, I will teach you. What are these? Symbols of electrical components. Students, you please listen my voice. If the word is not clear here, you please try to understand. You please listen my voice. Symbols of electrical components or electric components. Okay, students, here, what is this symbol? Can you name the symbol of electrical component? Yeah, what is this? Cell, battery cell. Okay, here you can see this long standing line represents positive and small standing line represents negative charge, positive and negative. Okay, see, if you take a battery cell from a TV remote or something, you know, if you see live battery cell, you will see these symbols on either sides of the battery cell. See here, I will draw the diagram. If it is like this, okay, on either sides you can see this is positive and this is negative. Yes, so positive side of the battery cell is represented in long standing line, and negative terminal of the battery cell is represented with short standing line, like this. Okay, and what are these? You know, copper wires. Copper wires. This is also copper wire. You know, this is the symbol of electrical component called battery cell. Second one, let us see it now. If you see the second one, this is copper wire. This is also copper wire. And what's there in between these two bits of copper wires? This is bulb. What is this? Symbol of bulb, of electrical component. Bulb is an electrical component. Okay, next. This is also bulb, but what difference do you notice here? That's good. This bulb is glowing. Okay, lighting bulb. This is, or else, glowing bulb. This is also symbol of bulb, but it is glowing, right? And this fourth component of electrical components, this fourth symbol of electrical component is, can you notice this? What do you say? That's right, switch. And this fifth component is also switch, but what difference do you notice? What is this? There is disconnection. That means the switch is off And then what is this? The switch is on. Here for bulb also same, the bulb is here off. And this bulb is on. Okay? This bulb is off and this bulb is on because it's glowing. And the switch is on. See, there is connection between these two copper wires. And the switch is off. There is disconnection between these two copper wires. Yes, so that we can say this switch is off. Next symbol of electrical component, see here. Can you notice what symbol of electrical component is this? Yeah. Standing line is always positive terminal. Sorry, long standing line is always positive terminal and short standing line is always negative terminal. Remember, students? Yeah. Here you can say this is battery cell and this is also battery cell. Here how many battery cells are here? 1 and 2. Okay, 2 battery cells are there. If 2 or more than 2 battery cells are connected, then that is called as battery. Okay, of course it's a battery cell, it's also a battery cell. But if 2 or more than 2 battery cells are connected, then that is called as battery. Okay, remember this statement, students. If 2 or more than 2 battery cells, you can connect another battery cell as well. See here, another long standing line, this is positive, short standing line, this is negative. If you go on connecting the battery cells like this, as many as you can here, that's considered as battery. Okay, like this. So here you can notice the difference here from the batteries, from the cell and battery. Of course, it's a battery cell, it's a unit. But there are many battery cells there, no, that is battery. Okay, and the sequence of arrangement of cells here you can see. Yeah, sequence, this is long standing line positive terminal, short standing line is negative terminal. Here this is long standing line, you know, it's little tall, right? It's short. So the connection between negative and positive, always that opposite charges are connected. You remember, if you take a torch light, see here, its barrel, the battery cells are inserted here. If one battery cell is inserted, this side is, for example, this side is negative and this side is positive, plus and minus, then next battery cell should always be inserted like this. This side positive, this side negative. See here, negative, yes, positive charge of this first battery cell is connected to negative side, negative charge side of the second battery cell here. You can see like this. Okay, the arrangement of the battery cells should always be like this, right? Next, last. This is fuse. This symbol represents, the symbol of electrical component is fuse. Okay, students. So these are the different symbols of electrical components that you please try to remember them, try to draw them in your notebook and present in our WhatsApp group. Okay, students. So this is about symbols of electrical components. Okay. Students, in the previous class, I have already taught you about arrangement of these electrical components in a systematic order and that makes a simple electric circuit. To make a simple electric circuit, we have to arrange a few of these electrical components in a sequence order. Okay, the order I will represent here on the board with diagram once again. I am teaching you what? Yeah. Name of the sub concepts related to this topic here, you please remember. Here I wrote. Yeah, next. Yeah. Simple electric circuit. Yeah. Can you recollect the arrangement of the electrical components in simple electric circuit? Yeah. Positive, negative. What is this? Cell. This is copper wire. This is also copper wire. Yeah. Next. Let us start from positive side, positive terminal onwards. The positive side copper wire is again connected with here. What is this? Key or switch. Okay. Can you say the switch position now? Whether on or off? That's right. The position is off. Okay. Next. You continue the copper wire like this. And here. What is this? Bulb. You can understand here the number of components arrangement here. How many components are here? How many electrical components are here? Here, cell, switch, bulb, and copper wire. Okay. See the order of arrangement. Order or sequence. Sequence of arrangement. You please remember, you please listen my voice. Here is not enough sufficient space to write this word here. Otherwise, I will write that side. Otherwise, I will write here. Sequence of arrangement of electrical components. See, here what are we talking about? Sequence of arrangement of electrical components. Here in simple electric circuit is an example to understand how the order or sequence of arrangement of electrical components first of all. See, first you take this positive terminal of the battery cell, and next this copper wire, and then switch and copper wire bulb and copper wire and negative terminal of the battery cell. See here, I will write in a word form. I will write here. Positive. I just mentioned a first letter as symbol here, positive. Next, copper wire. You please write complete word here, students. Don't simply write like this. As there is no space to write, I am just writing like this. You please try to understand. Positive, arrow mark, you remember. Copper wire, switch. Next, bulb, After switch, not bulb, copper wire, again copper wire. Next bulb, again copper wire. Next, negative, positive terminal and negative terminal. Next, yeah, negative terminal to positive terminal. See the flow of charges in such a sequence. See the arrangement of the components of electrical components like this. Students, the arrangement of or sequence of arrangement of electrical components are like this. Okay, and also here the flow of current should always flow in such a way. See, positive, this is positive and this is negative. Positive and negative. See the order. See, negative is following positive charge. Okay, this negative charge is following positive charge. See the direction of the flow of current. See, if in case if you miss this order, do you think the flow of current or the circuit gets broken? Okay, for example, you take the switch, the arrangement of the switch may be this side or maybe somewhere else. If you arrange the switch at any point of the circuit, no issue. There will no disturbance, or the flow of current will not get broken. The circuit will not get broken if the arrangement of switch is changed. Okay? But if the copper wire is disconnected at any point of the circuit, for example, here it is disconnected, no? So the flow of current is broken, the circuit is broken. Okay? Flow of current is broken here as the switch is in off position. Yes? As the switch is in off position, the flow of current is broken here. The arrangement of switch is not a matter here, but the copper wire should be connected in a proper arrangement. Okay? And also it's compulsory to arrange the components in such a way, except the switch. Switch may be there, may not be there. Okay? It's good if you arrange in such a sequence. It's good if you arrange the components in such a sequence. That's good and enough. The flow of current will be proper. Okay? This is about the arrangement of or order of sequence of arrangement of components. Okay, students, this is about the order of arrangement of electrical components in a simple electric circuit. Okay, students, next let's move forward. Don't forget that connection should be proper. See, the batteries, bulbs are connected with copper wire properly or not. Okay, students, you don't forget this, students, the sequence or the order of the arrangement of electrical components. I just wrote the first letter and some alphabet here to understand the name of the component, but you please write in complete sentence or complete word. Okay, switch, copper wire, see here, first positive order, this is first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, you know, the order is like this. Next, what I want to make you understand is, the arrangement of the electrical components, we have understood here only one electrical component is connected here. For example, you take bulb and battery here. Yeah, here we have understood that one bulb and one cell, the connection of one bulb and one cell in this circuit, simple electric circuit. If you increase the number of bulbs or if you increase the number of battery cells, how do you arrange them? How do you connect them? There are two ways to connect. Okay, what are those two ways and what do we call them and all? I will teach you that in the next class. Okay, for this video you have understood that symbols of electrical components and how you arrange the order of these electrical components. Okay students, you please write it in your notebook. What you have understood out of this video, you please present it in your notes in a sentence form and present it in our WhatsApp group students. Okay, in the next class, what I'm going to teach you? The types of connections with more bulbs and more battery cells. Okay, got it? This is for this video. Thank you for listening. Thank you one and all.